Hello, this is Dr. Jack Jackson, and welcome to a series of videos on probability and statistics. In this first video, we're going to be introducing the basic idea of probability and statistics, and we'll hopefully answer the question, what is statistics, a little bit here. Okay. So, you're going to see these things in my videos from time to time when I say start of homework set 1.1. These are for my students who are actually taking my class, either full online or on campus. And this is where homework set 1.1 will start with this video. So this is the first of a series of lectures, and the slides that you see here will be there from it. For a first course in probability statistics, the prerequisites for this material include basic arithmetic and really just first year algebra, algebra 1 from high school. You really don't really need to know a lot of algebra beyond that. At our university, it does require a college algebra prerequisite to get into this class, or I think college mathematics is also a way you can get in. But as far as how much algebra you actually need to know, it's quite little. But we do expect you to know a few basic things from first year algebra and certainly some basic things from arithmetic. But students with a firm understanding of K-8 mathematics and algebra 1 should be able to successfully complete this course and understand these videos without any further background. But I also want to point out that other than basic mathematics, basic arithmetic, probability and statistics is the most widely applicable area of mathematics. So you're going to see probability and statistics everywhere you look. It's used in every field. It's used in research journals, newspapers, and other everyday sources of information, both technical and more casual sources of information. So everyone should be familiar with the basic topics of this course. This should be a basic requirement, really, of every degree plan. So, what is statistics? Well, statistics is the science of data. It involves collecting, classifying, summarizing, organizing, analyzing, and interpreting numerical information. Probability and statistics allows us to quantify uncertainty in order to assist us in making meaningful predictions and decisions. And so, making quantifiable, data-driven decisions is the goal of probability and statistics. So, what we're trying to do is we're trying to get away from making decisions based on some, you know, vague gut feeling or some emotional context, but rather actually have some data to drive those decisions. And that is what the whole idea of probability and statistics is really about. And that's really what makes this such a powerful topic for us to study. So there are three main branches of probability and statistics that we're going to be studying in these videos and in this course. They are descriptive statistics, probability, and inferential statistics. And in fact, in my course, I will divide the course into three units. And you'll see that my slides shows are basically in three slideshows, one for each of the four units. And then there's a playlist that goes along with that in YouTube that you'll see, one for each of these four basic units. So unit one is descriptive statistics. That's where we're starting right here. Next, unit two will be discrete probability. Unit three, continuous probability. And then unit four, inferential statistics. Where we're really headed is toward inferential statistics, but unfortunately we need all of this information here from units 1, 2, and 3 before we can really get there. So let's take these sort of one at a time. Descriptive statistics uses numerical and graphical methods to make sense of data, and it allows us to effectively find and communicate important information from the data set in order to reach good conclusions and make good decisions. So, descriptive statistics organizes and makes sense of data. So we basically have this massive amount of data often, and it's just information overload. We've just got too much stuff. And so what we want to do is we want to pick out of that the important essential things out of that information, discard the rest, and take what we keep and organize it and make it sense so that it can be very quickly, easily, and effectively and correctly communicated to other people. So we're going to be using both numerical and graphical methods to do this. We use descriptive statistics to identify patterns in the data and key features of that. So it's going to isolate and summarize key information. And it simplifies the information, focusing on the items of interest. And this will allow us to eliminate undesired information to avoid information overload. So oftentimes in statistics, we actually decrease what we know, what's presented, in order to focus on what's really important. Probability is used to draw conclusions about the likelihood that an arbitrary sample will have certain characteristics given information about a known population it is drawn from. And it does this by assigning a numerical value between 0 and 1, inclusive, to this event, measuring a degree of uncertainty. So what probability does, it basically allows us to quantify uncertainty. In fact, everything that we do in probability and statistics, there's going to be a certain amount of uncertainty involved there. And that way, it's somehow different than other branches of mathematics because of that. So probability works from a known population or historical data. Basically, it goes from a population to a sample. In this sense, it's the inverse of inferential statistics, which goes the other direction. But what it does is assigns a numerical value from 0 to 1 to an uncertain event, identifying the likelihood that that event will happen. And so it gives a numerical measure to a degree of uncertainty. Now, this numerical measure might be in a decimal, fraction, percentage, or a ratio form. And it basically goes from a scale from 0 to 1. If the probability is 0, that's an impossible event, something that cannot happen. Probability is 1, that's an event that's certain to happen, absolutely will happen. Probability of 1/2 is equally likely to happen or not happen. Probabilities are between 0 and 1/2 are more likely to not happen than to happen, so a probability close to 0 would be a very unlikely event, whereas a probability close to 1 is a likely event. So the higher the probability, the more likely it is to occur. But it's always a number between 0 and 1. Now, inferential statistics is used to draw conclusions about a population given information about a representative sample and uses this information in good decision making. So what's happening here is it's too costly or perhaps even impossible to measure an entire population. So what we want to do is we take a sample from that, hopefully a representative sample, and from that sample then we can measure it and then deduce or infer what is going to happen about the entire population. And this is the really powerful part of probability and statistics, is when we get to the inferential statistics. So inferential statistics uses sample data. It makes estimates, predictions, generalizations, and decisions about a larger population. It uses sample data to infer population characteristics. And it goes then from sample to population. So in that sense, it's the opposite or inverse of probability. And it allows us to make data-based decisions, which is really the whole main point of probability statistics. And it goes a little bit further. It quantifies confidence in these decisions. So hopefully in this video, you've seen kind of an overview of basically what is statistics, what is probability. We'll get into this more in detail as we go through the various playlists that we have here, and we go through that. Now, you'll see in my videos, it'll say here, work homework problem 1.1, homework set 1.1, problem number 1. You're ready to answer that question now if you're in my class. Now, I might change these problems in a future semester, and in which case it will be it'll be indicated correctly in the new PowerPoint printouts, but I may not take the time to go back and re-record all these videos just for that one little thing. But as of now, this is the right time to go ahead and work at least that first problem on the homework. So anyway, hopefully you've learned something from this video. Get it started, and we'll continue on with this in the future.